is Becky, and I am here with the Virgin Gaming team. Sir Richard Branson to my left, of course, and then we have Billy and Zach, who are the two creators of the new Virgin Gaming. My first question actually goes to you, Richard. You had Virgin Gaming back in the 90s, and now Virgin Gaming again. Were you a gamer yourself?
I was once, and now I've gone into more sort of boring conventional games like backgammon and chess and things. But we loved originating games, and then we actually sold that company. And I just love the concept of what they've created with Virgin Gaming. You know, a way for people who are playing console games to be able to have a flutter and play people of their own skill level. Hopefully win some great prizes or win some great money.
Definitely. What was it about their concept that really was the kicker for you to join in?
Well, no one's doing it. I mean, it's not possible to have a flutter with friends playing console games on the internet, and it's not possible to to know that you're playing with people of the same skill level. So I think it was those two factors that made us think, if we put the Virgin brand to it, it could really explode.
Now, you guys met in college and actually play a competitive game. What was your game of choice back then?
We are just really competitive at everything. We didn't have a game of choice. We would just, whether we're playing for girls' telephone numbers, pizza, money, whatever it was, we're just always competing. But we play Madden, FIFA, UFC, every game pretty much.
So are girls' telephone numbers one of the prizes on Virgin Gaming then?
Well, with Richard bringing them to the table, absolutely.
I like that idea. I think the guys like that. Let's see. How do you guys think this will affect actual tournaments that are out there, like MLB or MLG and tournaments like that?
I think it's complementary towards what they're doing because they're so focused on live events and they do a great job at it. And we just take that concept and move it online. So you don't have to deal with the travel. You're doing it from the comfort of your own home, and it makes it a lot bigger. Instead of doing tournaments with, 6,428 people, now it's open to thousands and thousands and thousands of people around the world.
What would you give advice to the people at home who want to do the same kind of thing, who have a big idea in their head and want to make something like this come of it?
Screw it, just do it.
Yeah, never give
up.
Speaking.
Anyway. I'll see you.